For almost 13 years now, we have been working on to get the Atlantic sturgeon back to Sweden. And it's done now. It was one of the best things I ever done in my life.
The story of the sturgeon in Sweden is similar to the story of the sturgeon in the whole of Europe, meaning they were here originally before humans came. And humans came and humans found them very tasty and overfished them. And this took several hundred years. And eventually they were gone. This fish is an umbrella species. Whatever we do to the sturgeon will have a good and positive impact for the ecosystem as a whole. So if we save the sturgeon and make the population flourish, then we will have a good river, estuary, coastal system in good balance. In order to monitor this project properly, we tag the fish with an acoustic transmitter. And we also put out receivers along the river with the two branches and in the coastal areas. And this will make us a very good opportunity to follow the migration of the fish when it moves out in the ocean. And we will also learn if it goes north or south or directly out, and we can follow it. And with this, we can also in the future plan restoration activities that is needed in the river.
Many of the marine and coastal environments in Europe have been depleted because there's not a lot of fish anymore because of overfishing and bottom trawling. And so there's a huge need for no-take zones in marine and coastal areas. There's a huge need for restoring fish populations and other species that depend on fish. And there's also a huge opportunity for people to then reconnect with these coastal marine areas where marine life bounces back.
100 sturgeons does not make a population. It is only a start of a work that will be ongoing for a decade or two.
If we can rewild some parts and make them stay rewilded also, I think that will be something that future generation will be very, very thankful for. Because if we don't have these places, I think we're gonna have some real trouble that we don't even can see now.